chances are that you're watching this on a portable device right now, like a phone or even a laptop. And all of these devices have batteries inside of them. How do those batteries even work, and how are they able to be recharged and reused? And does that eventually degrade the battery and affect its lifespan? Well, in this episode, I'm going to take you behind the science of electricity, batteries, lithium-ion batteries, break down how they work, and what really caused them to degrade over time, and all the science behind that right here in this episode. Let's get right into the science. Let's go. To break down how a battery works, we have to break it into the different pieces of the battery. And there are a few pieces that go into it: the electrodes, the electrolyte, and the separator. A battery has two electrodes, a positive electrode known as the cathode, and a negative electrode known as the anode. There's also an electrolyte, which is a liquid or gel that allows these ions to move through the electrodes. And there's a separator that prevents direct contact between both of the electrodes. So, the common type of battery that we all use is called a dry cell battery. And these parts basically work together. The electrolyte is a set of chemicals, and eventually a chemical reaction occurs. That reaction causes a large quantity of electrons to build up in the anode, but electrons want to flow to the cathode. Electrons in a row are what caused electricity to happen in the first place. As these electrons want to flow to the cathode, there's no way, but the electrolyte and the separator prevents that. But when it's connected to a circuit, that's when these electrons can flow through the circuit freely. That's how you can power these different loads like your TV remote or even your mouse. And that's how these standard batteries work, is because of these electrons flowing from the anode to the cathode. Now, what about reusable batteries and rechargeable batteries, like the batteries inside your phone or even your laptop? How do those work? Well, those work a little bit differently. The most common type of rechargeable battery is known as a lithium-ion battery, and it's used in phones and laptops and all these personal portable devices. Now, how does this type of battery even work? Remember the anode and cathode and the chemical reaction we talked about? Well, in this case, this chemical reaction is somehow reversible, and we'll get to that soon, and that's all thanks to electricity. That's why you plug in your phone to charge it. So what is the charging process of a lithium ion battery? Well, first off, these lithium ions flow from the cathode to the anode, and electricity kind of forces that to happen. So when you charge your phone, these lithium ions that are inside the battery are moving from the cathode to the anode, and this is what the charging process is. Now, what about the discharging process? When you turn on your phone and when you start using it, what causes the battery to deplete and eventually die? Well, this reaction kind of reverses. When you turn your phone on, the process reverses and lithium ions move back from the anode to the cathode. And this movement of ions generates a flow of electrons. Remember how we said a flow of electrons is what electricity is? Well, that is how the phone is powered. And this is how your rechargeable batteries work. Now, eventually, these lithium ions keep going back and forth and back and forth and back and forth, charging, discharging, charging, discharging. But everything has the end to its life, and especially these batteries, lithium ion batteries, they can't take in as much charge as they were when they were brand new. That's why if you have an older phone or an older laptop and older devices, you might notice that you have to charge your phone or your device more frequently throughout the day. And that's because these lithium ion batteries start to deplete over time. And over 10 years or even over 2 years, these devices can start depleting. And that's all because of these lithium ions. And eventually these lithium ions start wearing out, and the anode and cathode start physically wearing out. These chemical reactions don't occur as normal, and that's why you have to charge your phone faster, and that's why when you get older devices, the fast charging just goes away, because as these devices get older, these lithium ions have trouble moving and recharging and discharging. So that is why lithium ion batteries kind of wear out over time and degrade over time. But this is how lithium ion batteries work. These batteries are so convenient because they're so small. They fit inside the palm of your hand, which is where your phones are. They even fit in smartwatches and laptops and all of these portable electronic devices. And these lithium ion batteries are what enables us to basically go everywhere with their devices. So I charge my phone about once every day, and it varies based on your phone and how much you use your phone and all that. That's why I was curious about it, and I asked my listeners on Instagram how often they charge their phone, and here is what they said. so much for your responses. If you want your response to be featured on upcoming episodes, follow me on Instagram at SpectacularSciPod. There you can find all this information and ways to participate for you to be featured on these upcoming episodes through these polls and Q&As. So follow me on Instagram at SpectacularSciPod. Thank you so much. All right, let's review what we learned in this episode about rechargeable batteries and batteries in general. All right, what did we learn in this episode? This episode, we learned that batteries work using an anode and cathode and an electrode. And these electrodes are linked by an electrolyte. And what happens is that these electrons start moving due to a chemical reaction. And that is how batteries generate electricity and they work. Eventually, they die because these electrodes and these chemicals eventually wear off over time. Now, rechargeable batteries work in a similar but a little different way. These rechargeable batteries, the most common type is a lithium-ion battery. What happens is that these lithium ions get charged up and these electricities force it to move from one side to another. And when it gets used, it moves from the other side to the other side of the battery. And this causes a flow of electrons to happen, which is what electricity is. And these lithium-ion batteries can degrade over time due to use and recharging and discharging of these batteries, because eventually these lithium-ion batteries just don't move as well as they did when they were new. And eventually these anodes and cathodes and all these electrolytes, they wear off over time. And that's why your battery life can get worse over time on all your devices. It's just how lithium-ion batteries work. All right, thank you so much for listening to this episode of Spectacular Science. Spectacular Science, produced and hosted by me, Akshay Jayaraman, and theme song edition music art by Chan Ramachandran. Please visit my podcast website, spectacularsci.com, to find interactive activities, articles, and blog posts. That's spectacularsci.com. If you have a science question and answer on a Spectacular Science episode and get a special shout-out, well, head over to spectacularsci.com/contact. There you can find a contact form, you can send me your amazing science questions, and you can also tag me on Instagram at SpectacularSciPod. That's at SpectacularSciPod. Thank you so much. Don't forget to buy your Spectacular Science merch at shop.spectacularsci.com. You can get hoodies, t-shirts, and more. That's shop.spectacularsci.com. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this podcast for listening right now. It really encourages me and you to update on all the new episodes. So go ahead and subscribe and share this podcast with your friends and family. Thank you so much. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you on the next episode of Spectacular Science next week. In the meantime, keep your phone fully charged and see you on the next episode of Spectacular Science. Keep thinking about science.